Hey everyone, welcome again. I know it is being tough for you to learn something like this, but as if now we really don't have any option. So this is what we can do. So moving forward to our topic of physiology. Last time we have seen the exchange of respiratory gases. So we'll continue with the transport of respiratory gases. Again, it is being asked in 5 marks, sometimes combined with exchange and transport of respiratory gases, and sometimes as in 5 marks, and you have to describe the whole process and phenomena. So yeah, let's start. So our topic is transport of respiratory gases. Introduction. Blood serves to transport the respiratory gases. Oxygen, which is essential for the cell, is transported from alveoli of lungs to the cells, and carbon dioxide, which is the waste product in cell, is transported from cell to lungs. Now the transportation che e bai bhag ni andar divide thai. First is the transport of oxygen and the second is transport of carbon dioxide. Firstly, we'll see a transport of oxygen. So oxygen is transported from alveoli to the tissue by blood in 2 forms. First, as simple physical solution, and second, in combination with hemoglobin. So this is the one table which shows the gases in arterial and venous blood. Jyare apde agar jem jem vadta jaisu, to we have to keep this in mind. So if we are talking about the oxygen, I know the partial pressure chhe e arterial blood ni andar 95 mmHg hoy, ane oxygen nu venous blood ni andar partial pressure 40 mmHg hoy. Jyare oxygen chhe nu content arterial blood ma 19 ml% and venous blood ma 14 ml%. And if we are talking about the carbon dioxide, to carbon dioxide nu partial pressure arterial blood ni andar 40 mmHg and venous blood ma 46 mmHg, and carbon dioxide no content hai arterial blood ni andar 48 ml%, and venous blood ni andar it is carbon dioxide content is 52 ml%. So apne je baat kari ke transport of oxygen che bai rite thai, to first is as simple solution, to how it works. So oxygen dissolves in water of plasma and is transported in this physical form. Amount of oxygen transported in this way is very negligible. It is only 0.3 ml per 100 ml of plasma. So it forms only about 3% of total oxygen in blood. So aaj method chhe ena dwara only 3% of oxygen chhe e blood ni andar combine thai. So it is because poor solubility of oxygen in water content of plasma. Still, transport of oxygen in this form becomes important during the conditions like muscular exercise to meet the excess demand of oxygen by the tissues. And the second one is in combination with hemoglobin. Oxygen combines with hemoglobin in blood and it is transported by transported as oxyhemoglobin. Transport of oxygen in this form is important because maximum amount 97% of oxygen is transported by this method. Abhi je pehla je method ni baat kari thi, ena through only 3% je cha transportation thatu hai cha, but by this method 97% of oxygen is being transported. Now we'll see the oxygenation of hemoglobin. Okay, so before that, I would like to let you know 2 different definitions. One is oxygenation and the second is oxidation. So what can be the difference between these two phenomena or process? So firstly, we are talking about the oxygenation. So oxygenation in the this is a physical combination only, and it is just oxygen na je pan molecules che ena medium sathe combine thai che. If you are talking about the blood, તો એ બ્લડ સાથે કમ્બાઈન થાય છે, જેમાં એનું જે કેમિકલ કોમ્પોઝિશન છે એ ચેન્જ નથી થતું, તો દેટ ઇઝ ઓક્સિજનેશન. તો આ ઓક્સિજનેશનની જે પ્રોસેસ છે એની અંદર ઓક્સિજન છે એ મીડિયમ સાથે રિએક્ટ નથી થતું, પણ ખાલી જે સિમ્પલી જે છે એની સાથે એડ થાય છે, અને એટ ધ સેમ ટાઈમ ઇટ ઇઝ વેરી ઇઝી ટુ સેપરેટ દેટ ઓલ્સો. એ જે કોમ્બિનેશન બન્યું છે એને સેપરેટ કરવું પણ ઇટ ઇઝ વેરી ઇઝી. અને જ્યારે આપણે ઓક્સિડેશનની વાત કરીએ તો ઓક્સિડેશનની અંદર ઓક્સિજન રિએક્ટ્સ વિથ ધ મીડિયમ એન્ડ ચેન્જીસ ઇટ્સ કેમિકલ કોમ્પોઝિશન. સો દેટ ઇઝ અ બેઝિક ડિફરન્સ. સો નાવ મૂવિંગ ફોરવર્ડ ટુ આર ટોપિક, ઓક્સિજનેશન ઓફ હિમોગ્લોબિન. ઓક્સિજન કમ્બાઇન્સ વિથ હિમોગ્લોબિન ઓનલી એઝ ફિઝિકલ કોમ્બિનેશન. ઇટ ઇઝ ઓનલી ઓક્સિજનેશન એન્ડ નોટ ઓક્સિડેશન. This type of combination of oxygen with hemoglobin has got some advantages. Oxygen can be readily released from hemoglobin when it is needed. Hemoglobin accepts oxygen readily wherever the partial pressure of oxygen in the blood is more. Hemoglobin gives out oxygen whenever the partial pressure of oxygen in the blood is less. Oxygen combines with the iron in heme part of hemoglobin. Each molecule of hemoglobin contains 4 atoms of iron. Iron of the hemoglobin is present in ferrous form. Each iron atom combines with one molecule of oxygen. After combination, iron remains in ferrous form only. That is why the combination of oxygen with hemoglobin is called oxygenation and not oxidation. So we have seen this while understanding the basic difference. Now, oxygen carrying capacity of hemoglobin. Oxygen carrying capacity of hemoglobin is the amount of oxygen transported by 1 gram of hemoglobin, and it is 1.34 ml per gram. And oxygen carrying capacity of blood. Oxygen carrying capacity of blood refers to the amount of oxygen transported by blood. So normal hemoglobin content is in blood is 15 gram percent. Since oxygen carrying capacity of hemoglobin is 1.34 ml per gram, blood with 15 gram of hemoglobin should carry 20.1 ml percent of oxygen. So 20.1 ml of oxygen in 100 ml of blood. But here, blood with 15 gram of hemoglobin carries only 19 ml of oxygen. 19 ml of oxygen is carried by 100 ml of blood, where oxygen carrying capacity of blood is only 19 ml percent because the hemoglobin is not fully saturated with oxygen. It is saturated only for about 95%. So, oxygen carrying capacity of blood would be 19 ml percent. Jare hemoglobin ni 1.34 ml per gram. So, saturation of hemoglobin with oxygen joye. Saturation is the state of condition when hemoglobin is unable to hold or carry any more oxygen. Saturation of hemoglobin with oxygen depends upon partial pressure of oxygen, and it is explained by oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve. Oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve. Again, it is important. Oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve is a curve that demonstrates a relationship between partial pressure of oxygen and the percentage saturation of hemoglobin with oxygen. Normally in blood, hemoglobin is saturated with oxygen only up to 95%. Saturation of hemoglobin with oxygen depends upon the partial pressure of when the partial pressure of oxygen is more, hemoglobin accepts oxygen, and when the partial pressure of oxygen is less, hemoglobin releases the oxygen. Normal oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve. Under normal conditions, oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve is S-shaped or sigmoid shaped. lower part of the curve indicates disassociation of oxygen from hemoglobin, and upper part of the curve indicates the uptake of oxygen by hemoglobin depending upon partial pressure of oxygen. Now there is a term called P50. So what is that? P50 is the partial pressure of oxygen at which hemoglobin saturation with oxygen is 50%. And when the partial pressure of oxygen is 25 to 27 mmHg, the hemoglobin is saturated to about 50%. That is, the blood contains 50% of oxygen. So at 40 mmHg of partial pressure of oxygen, the saturation would be 75%, and it becomes 95% when the partial pressure of oxygen is 100 mmHg. So there are different factors which are affecting the oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve. So oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve is shifted to left or right by various factors. So aaj generally question pan pucha to hoy che ke factors responsible for left shifting of left or shifting of right. So ipan again 5 marks inder pucha hai, so you should have to have some idea. So first jo ye shift to left indicates acceptance or association of oxygen by hemoglobin, and second is shift to right indicates dissociation of oxygen from hemoglobin. So first shift to right, aaj curve che right shift thai to any na kaya kaya factors responsible hoy. So oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve is shifted to right in the following conditions. First, decrease in partial pressure of oxygen. Second, increase in partial pressure of carbon dioxide, jene apne Bohr effect pan kehvay, je apne agar jo issue what is that. Third is increase in hydrogen ion concentration and decreased in pH, matlab acidity. Increased, fourth is increased body temperature, and fifth is excess of 2,3 diphosphoglycerate, which is called DPG in RBC. It is also called 2,3 biphosphoglycerate, which is BPG. Okay, so next is shift to left. Oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve is shifted to left in the following condition. First, in fetal blood, because fetal hemoglobin has got more affinity for oxygen than the adult hemoglobin. Affinity matlab any sathe je jodavani je pan prakriya chhe, matlab any attract kare chhe. And the second is decrease in hydrogen ion concentration and increase in pH. So apne agar jare factors jo jata tyare that was a term called Bohr effect. So what is that? So Bohr effect is the effect by which presence of carbon dioxide decreases the affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. So Bohr effect was postulated by Christian Bohr in 1904. In tissues, due to continuous metabolic activities, the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is very high and the partial pressure of oxygen is low. Due to this pressure gradient, carbon dioxide enters the blood and oxygen is released from blood to the tissue. So presence of carbon dioxide decreases the affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. It enhances the further release of oxygen to the tissue, and oxygen dissociation curve is shifted to right. So factors influencing Bohr effects, so all the factors which shift the oxygen dissociation curve to right enhances the Bohr effect. Je panch factors batavya tha, e badha factors responsible chhe Bohr effect mate pan. Next is transport of carbon dioxide. So apne agar jo transport of oxygen, now moving forward to transport of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is transported by the blood from cells to the alveoli. So carbon dioxide ni je transportation ni je pan process chhe, e char rite thai. Jem apne oxygen ma joyu, transport of oxygen bai method it hatu hoy, to carbon dioxide char method it thai chhe. First is as dissolved form, which is of 7%. Second is as carbonic acid, which is negligible. Third is as bicarbonate, which is 63%. And fourth is as carbamino compounds, that is 30%. So first, as a dissolved form, carbon dioxide diffuses into blood and dissolves in the fluid of plasma, forming a simple solution. Only about 3 ml per 100 ml of plasma of carbon dioxide is transported as dissolved state. It is about 7% of total carbon dioxide in the blood. Second is as carbonic acid. Part of dissolved carbonic acid in plasma combines with the water to form carbonic acid. Transport of carbon dioxide in this form is negligible. Third is as bicarbonate. About 63% of carbon dioxide is transported as bicarbonate. From plasma, carbon dioxide enters the RBCs. In the RBCs, carbon dioxide combines with water to form carbonic acid. The reaction inside RBC is very rapid because of the presence of carbonic anhydrase. Now this enzyme accelerates the reaction. Carbonic anhydrase is present only inside the RBCs and not in plasma. That is why carbonic acid formation at least become 200 to 300 times more in RBC than in plasma. So carbonic acid is very unstable. Almost all carbonic acid form in red blood corpuscles disassociates into bicarbonate and hydrogen ions. So concentration of bicarbonate ions in the cell increases more and more. Due to high concentration, bicarbonate ion diffuses through the cell membrane into plasma. So જે આપણે બોર ઇફેક્ટ જોઈ એવી બીજી એક ઇફેક્ટ છે દેટ ઇઝ કોલ્ડ ક્લોરાઇડ શિફ્ટ ઓર હેમબર્ગર ફિનોમિના. સો ક્લોરાઇડ શિફ્ટ ઓર હેમબર્ગર ફિનોમિના ઇઝ ધ એક્સચેન્જ ઓફ ક્લોરાઇડ આયન ફોર અ બાયકાર્બોનેટ આયન અક્રોસ આરબીસી મેમ્બ્રેન. સો ઇટ વોઝ ડિસ્કવર્ડ બાય હાર્ટોગ જેકોબ હેમબર્ગર ઇન 1892. ક્લોરાઇડ શિફ્ટ અકર્સ વેન કાર્બન ડાયોક્સાઇડ એન્ટર્સ ધ બ્લડ ફ્રોમ ટિશ્યુ. In plasma, plenty of sodium chloride is present. It dissociates into sodium and chloride ions when the negatively charged bicarbonate ions move out of RBC into the plasma. So the negatively charged chloride ion move into the RBC in order to maintain the electrolyte equilibrium. That is called ionic balance. Anion exchanger 1, which acts like antipode pump in RBC membrane, is responsible for the exchange of bicarbonate ion and chloride ion. Bicarbonate ion combines with sodium ion in the plasma and forms sodium bicarbonate. In this form, it is transported in the blood. Hydrogen ion dissociated from carbonic acid and buffered by hemoglobin inside the cell. So we'll see a reverse chloride shift now. Reverse chloride shift is a process by which chloride ions are moved back into the plasma from RBC shift. It occurs in lungs. It helps in elimination of carbon dioxide from the blood. So bicarbonate is converted back into carbon dioxide, which has to be expelled on takes place by following mechanism. When blood reaches the alveoli, sodium bicarbonate in plasma disassociate into sodium and bicarbonate ions. Bicarbonate ion moves into the RBC. It makes chloride ion to move out to the RBC into the plasma, where it combines with sodium and forms sodium chloride. So bicarbonate ion inside the RBC combines with hydrogen ion, forms carbonic acid, which dissociates into water and carbon dioxide. So now carbon dioxide is expelled out. The fourth way is as carbamino compounds. So about 30% of the carbon dioxide is transported as carbamino compounds. So carbon dioxide is transported into blood in combination with hemoglobin and plasma proteins. Carbon dioxide combines with hemoglobin to form carbaminohemoglobin or carbhemoglobin, and it combines with plasma protein to form carbaminoproteins. So carbaminohemoglobin and carbaminoproteins are together called carbaminocompounds. Carbon dioxide combines with proteins or hemoglobin with a loose bond so that carbon dioxide is easily released into alveoli, where the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is low. Thus, the combination of carbon dioxide with proteins and hemoglobin is a reversible one. Amount of carbon dioxide transported in combination with plasma protein is very less compared to the amount transported in combination with hemoglobin. So it is because the quantity of plasma is only half of the quantity of hemoglobin. So now moving forward to carbon dioxide dissociation curve. Carbon dioxide is transported in blood as physical solution and in combination with water, plasma proteins and hemoglobin. The amount of carbon dioxide combines with blood depends upon the partial pressure of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide dissociation curve is a curve that demonstrates the relationship between the partial pressure of carbon dioxide and the quantity of carbon dioxide that combines with blood. Normal carbon dioxide dissociation curve. Normal carbon dioxide dissociation curve shows that carbon dioxide content in the blood is 48 ml% when the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 40 mmHg and it is 52 ml% when the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 48 mmHg. So carbon dioxide content becomes 70 ml% when the partial pressure is about 100 mmHg. Now we'll see the Haldane effect. Haldane effect is the effect by which combination of oxygen with hemoglobin displaces carbon dioxide from hemoglobin. It was firstly described by John Scott Haldane in 1860. Excess of oxygen content in blood causes shift of the carbon dioxide dissociation curve to right. Causes for Haldane effect due to the combination with oxygen, hemoglobin, comes strongly acidic. It causes displacement of carbon dioxide from hemoglobin in two ways. First is highly acidic hemoglobin has low tendency to combine with carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide is displaced from blood. Because of the acidity, hydrogen ions are released in excess. Hydrogen ion binds with bicarbonate ions to form carbonic acid. Now carbonic acid in turn dissociates into water and carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide is released from blood into alveoli. So what is the significance of Haldane effect? So Haldane effect is essential for release of carbon dioxide from blood into the alveoli and uptake of oxygen by the blood. So that was it. And if you are having query regarding this, so please let me know how to reach to me.